Chang'an Avenue is an urban thoroughfare in Beijing, sandwiched between the Imperial Forbidden City and the Communist Tiananmen Square. To the north is the palace from the Ming and Qing dynasties. To its south, the vast Tiananmen Square with the monument to people's heroes and the Mao Memorial in the center. After the fall of the Qing Empire in 1911, Chang'an Avenue started to grow in both length and width, destroying the imperial structures on its way. Especially after the founding of the People's Republic of China in 1949, when the avenue was developed into the east-west axis of the Chinese capital. Since then, the street has been filled with monumental facades. This makes Chang'an Avenue the most important public space in the 20th century China, displaying a variety of architectural styles. Some of them are old, and some of them are new. The building with the golden roof on the left was from the 18th century, and the wall on the right was built in 1912. This building was built in the 1950s, considered modern then. Another 1950s building, Soviet in style. This one is with the so-called National Four. It is one of the 10 great buildings for the 10th anniversary for the People's Republic of China. In the 1970s, the diplomatic projects were built along Chang'an Avenue after the normalization of Sino-US relationship. In the 1980s and 90s, modernism revived. So did the nationalism. The commercial buildings try to occupy every inch of the site, while the political ones leave vast empty outdoor spaces for ritual ceremonies. The two facades of the Chang'an Avenue become collaged scrolls of historical evolvement of modern Chinese architecture. Chang'an Avenue is also the converging site for art, modernity, and political ideology. The closer you walk toward the central section, the more soldiers and guards you see. In this interdisciplinary study, I explore the process and the deep structure of the Chinese architectural modernization. I argue that Chinese architectural modernization was framed in a way that could never been fully achieved, with the very definition of modernity changed constantly. And Chang'an Avenue is a symbol of this unachievable modernization project. each period claimed to basically complete the avenue according to its own ideal of modernization, filling its two sides with monumental facades for national ceremonies. Yet each completion left new gaps, physically as well as symbolically, for future completions to fill. Drawing on Chang'an Avenue's historical ties and modern transformation, this book provides both a big picture of Beijing's urban texture alteration and the details in the design process of individual building, both theoretical controversies and practical considerations, and both political contexts and professional developments in reshaping China's built environment in the past century. The narrative of the avenue's metamorphosis thus generates not only a richness of archival materials, for instance, the rarely exposed 1964 planning, but also profound analysis of changes in architectural styles, shifts in art ideology, organizational approaches to artistic creation, the mechanism of political interference, and the impact of globalization. Chang'an Avenue is big, wide, long, and monumental. But right around it, there are still quite some traditional courtyards. Being screened behind walls and magnificent facades, they look older than they really are. These are gaps. I don't know when they will be filled. Chang'an Avenue is still evolving. New buildings are being added, and old facades refurbished. And my Chang'an Avenue study will continue. Thank you for watching.